Hi, you have found Rides with Chuck. In this video, we're going to take a look at a 1935 Auburn Speedster. I came across this car at the AutoHistorica in Highland Park, Illinois. And like all good car shows, the time to get there is in the morning when the cars are setting up. Be advised, there are a couple of audio glitches in this video, so don't blame YouTube or your internet provider.
Okay, what have we got here?
Thank you. It's a 35 Auburn supercharged boat-tail speedster.
Now this is fiberglass, right?
Oh, wrong. I have 25 years of working on this. These speedsters to know they're not fiberglass.
What separates this car from all the others of that era? How is this one special?
Well, this is really, really probably what I think of as probably one of the great automotive values of all time, because this car was a hand-built, supercharged supercar of the era that was available for around $2,000. So for $2,000, you got a truly hand-built, customized, supercharged speedster with looks that never stopped. And it was a car that Auburn built to promote sales and get people into their showrooms. Originally, they had only planned on building 12 prototype units and put them in the showroom windows to generate traffic so they'd get ma and pa in and sell a sedan. And it turned out that the public outcry for this car was so great that they decided to go into production and use up a lot of their leftover speedster bodies from the 33 and 34 cars. So these early speedsters, up through about car number 80, 89 or 90, were actually modified 32 to 33 speedster bodies that Gordon Biehrig did a design change on, and then remodeled it to introduce this car. It's got a Lycoming straight eight supercharged engine, small displacement. I think it's about 262.
Can we see the
engine? Sure.
This car belongs to Paul Hedberg. He and his late wife Katie found the car, bought it. It is not restored. This is the car.
That is really nice.
Anyway, I bought this car. I found it in Baltimore, Maryland in 1984 and embarked upon a 25-year restoration, which we just completed last year. So we've got about 300 miles on it now, and it's a great car. It handles and drives beautifully. It's almost too modern a car. It's almost too, feels too much like a modern car.
It handles well?
Oh, it handles beautifully, yeah. I like antique cars to feel like antique cars, and this one's almost too modern. You don't get the same sense of having a challenge driving it. But it's a great car, and the styling's beautiful, and it's one of our Illinois natives, Gordon Biehrig's best work, and we're real proud to have it.
Illinois native?
Yeah. You're welcome.